Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Kicking off today's video, there are a couple of Falcon 9 launches expected over the next couple of days. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the Starlink 4-13 mission is scheduled to lift off tomorrow, Thursday 12th at 10:29pm UTC or 6:29pm EDT. Also on the SpaceX fans website, you can see the launch of Starlink 4-15 is scheduled to lift off on Friday 13th at 6:08am UTC or 2:08am EDT. The astronaut who will be the pilot of the first Polaris mission, Scott Petit, said some stuff about the first of multiple Polaris missions. Talking about Jared Isaacman, this article says the Polaris Dawn crew also includes Petit and SpaceX lead space operations engineers Anna Menon and Sarah Gillis. They will launch from historic Pad 39A at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida no sooner than 1st of November 2022, riding SpaceX's twice-flown Dragon Resilience. Talking about Starlink in reference to the usage in Ukraine with the war, somebody posted some tweets I want to share. The first says, one of the lesser-known features of SpaceX's Starlink internet service point-to-point email service for Starlink users encrypted and not using any ground infrastructure whatsoever. There were also some posts saying when the LaserCom-equipped SpaceX Gen 1.5 and 2 satellites come online, the ability to move huge amounts of bandwidth with zero ground-based infrastructure will utterly subvert the ability of national governments and corporations to block or surveil Starlink communications. Over at SpaceX's engine testing facility in McGregor, Texas, there have been some Raptor explosions over the last few days. Michael Baylor posted a tweet saying, "Raptor Rudd on the test stand in McGregor. Second one in 2 days, but also the first Rudds we have captured over the last month or so. SpaceX is firing Raptors several times a day, continually pushing the engines to better understand the limits." Heading to Boca Chica, the Raptor installation platform was seen move to the orbital launch site. The suborbital Pad A mount is being prepared for Ship 24's testing campaign. Here's a view of the high bay on the right and the mega bay on the left. Star Factory is continuing to progress. The self-propelled modular transporters were moved underneath Ship 16 to move it somewhere. The mega bay now has its first guest with the old Starship 16 moved inside. As we saw, the Ship 24 body section was moved into the high bay. Then, earlier in the week, the nose cone was stacked with the body to form Starship 24. Starship Gazer posted a great shot on Twitter of the stacked Starship 24 prototype. What's cool about this picture is you can see the little cutout which is assumed to be a Starlink dispenser for the first orbital flight. Prior to Monday, work continued inside Booster 7 at the launch site. The quick disconnect was also connected in preparation for testing. On Monday, SpaceX performed a cryogenic proof test of Booster 7. Now let's take a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website for testing. With further testing of Super Heavy Booster 7 on Monday, the road and beach closure on Tuesday was cancelled. However, there is a closure scheduled for today, Wednesday 11th, with other possible closures tomorrow, Thursday 12th and Friday 13th. Here's a view of the Booster 8 liquid oxygen section moved outside for Booster 7. Work has been continuing on it whilst Ship 24 is in the high bay. Like usual, I have to say thank you to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.